Namaste everyone. Welcome back to another session of Yoga with Reena. I hope you're all staying happy and healthy. And today's session is going to be working on our upper body. Okay, so just breaking down the sections as we go along. I wanted to focus on the upper part of the body today. So lots of work on our arms, our shoulders and our spines, and also working our hips. That's not to say we won't be using our legs, but nevertheless, it's really important that we work the upper body, and the next time we'll be working the lower part. So, if we can come into a nice comfortable sitting position, let's be aware of our surroundings, our health and safety, so appropriate clothing, enough space around us, no socks on, no slipping, and just making sure that you're aware of your own body's limitations and just personal health and safety. So be mindful of that before we begin. We can start by sitting in Sukhasana with one leg on top. So back up nice and straight, and we'll start with a kriya today. So just palms facing up on our knees, thumb and index finger touching. And we're sitting up nice and straight. Okay, so not putting too much pressure on the spine. We want to make sure the lungs are nice and empty. So we'll work on this for a minute. We're going to do our Kapalbhati practice, which is the forceful exhalation and the passive inhaling. So anyone with any high blood pressure or migraines, I would definitely recommend to sit this one out. We can just do some slow breathing in and out. And if your body is able to and you're fine in doing so, I would definitely suggest that you just take it slow. Okay, so in this practice, you'll be making this sound. So keep the tongue nice and relaxed and keep the jaw nice and relaxed. And if at any point you want to hit pause and you want to carry on for longer, by all means do so. So let's make sure we are in a nice, comfortable position. We can close our eyes, just take a few moments to come into your body, into the room. And to really just take some time just for your body now, okay? So taking a nice inhale and exhale, spending time on that exhale, taking a nice deep breath in and out. And then pumping the exhale, one per second, and really feeling your stomach move in and out as you're doing so. So visualize your stomach, keep that jaw nice and relaxed, and nothing else on the face should be moving, okay? So let's start that practice. Keep going, we've done about 10. I want you to keep pushing out from your nose, keep your tongue nice and relaxed, making sure we're not leaning forward, so keep that pump going. We're probably about 15 now, so keep pumping, exhale, and making sure there's no inhaling. It will happen very naturally on your own. Pump, 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 keep pumping. We're coming up to halfway now. Almost up there, keep pumping now. Your last 15 or so, so I want you to really give it everything you've got. That doesn't mean screw the face up or tighten the jaw, it means put a little bit more pressure in your exhale. Keep pumping, come on, off we go. Keep coming, and your last 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1, and complete the practice and be nice and still. You can gulp your saliva, you can relax your hands, and you can just be nice and still and enjoy that heat that has traveled through the upper body, pumping everything out. Making sure the upper body is nice and relaxed. We're not putting any pressure on the spine. up nice and straight. You'll find that you have managed to control your breath a little bit more with the Kapalbhati practice. And again, the more you do, the better this is. But if you're continuing with me, then just open your eyes with a few blinks and just take a nice big stretch all the way up. We're stretching all the way and increasing the length of our spine as we go, just pulling ourselves out. Keep coming as much as you can. Good, good, good. And keep that chin up, and now the palms are going to come behind. Okay, so chin all the way up, and you want to arch your spine now, yeah? So breathing in one, and breathing out the other side. Okay, really just pump, pump, pump. Okay, and just try and extend that spine as much as you possibly can. Yep, as much as you possibly can. And the most important thing is that spine will stretch more when your chin is up, okay? Now place your hands behind your head and breathe in and breathe out. So, just gonna continue the extending of the upper body. So hands down on the side. Okay, and we're going to be doing inhale up and exhale down, okay? So just breathing in, inhale, stretch those fingers, and exhale, and come all the way down. Keep exhaling until those hands reach the bottom, okay? Next one, interlock your hands, inhale, stretch up, 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 up. Nice big smiles, try and arch yourself back, and exhale. Okay, and last one, hands are going to come up from the front. This time you're going to have to use your back muscles a little bit more, okay, because we're not going to interlock them at the top. So when they're interlocked, your back is a little bit more controlled and it doesn't feel as heavy. But we're going to increase now. So inhale all the way up. So lean forward, put the stretch into your legs slightly and look up, 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 up. And exhale and come all the way down. Okay, and let's start with our necks now. So inhale, neck up. Try and keep the spine really relaxed as you're doing this, yeah? And chin down as you exhale. Inhale up, exhale to the right. And inhale, middle, exhale left. And then back to the middle. And just lightly from side to side, ear to shoulder, really going at your own pace and making sure we're not aggravating any of these muscles. Okay, you can use your hands and just press the shoulders lightly, loosen everything up. Okay, we're gonna be needing all of these muscles later. So shoulders back, nice big circles, two, three, and forwards, one, two, three. Okay, and then hands on your shoulders and taking a nice deep breath in. Touch those elbows together and really stretch the back. Yeah, stretch, 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 and open, and stretch. So we're really just tightening all of this as they're touching, and breathe out. And then from here, with your shoulders muscles really stretching out, I want you to just rotate your wrists, okay? So don't let your shoulders go just yet. Hopefully we are holding them up. Rotate those fingers and keep flicking. Okay, and good. And now you can relax the shoulders as well. So bringing our legs to a normal crossing and twisting side to side. Okay, really working that spine as much as we can, okay? And then nice and slowly, if we just bring our legs out in front of us, okay? And then just, you can wriggle the toes, okay? Just hit the legs up and down. Okay, really just working the back of the legs and tighten the knees and relax and tighten the knees and relax and tighten the knees and relax. And now lift those heels all the way up, 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 and point the toes without the heels touching the floor. Yeah, really important to make sure that we're stretching those calves out as well. Yeah, so we'll focus on the lower body in our next session. We just want to focus on the upper body in this one. Okay, so if you're able to, no hands please. We are going to use our legs to help ourselves get all the way up. So hopefully everyone is nice and comfortable, okay? If I can just ask you to bring your legs slightly open and just rotate your hips, okay, all the way around, okay, just once or twice, because we're actually going to be turning to the side for our first posture, yeah? So just nice big rotations, and then you can bring your legs all the way Okay, so first posture today is going to be Ardha Kati Chakrasana. So that's a half wheel, yeah? And you can do this in a variation. You can do this with your legs apart, you can do this with your feet slightly apart or feet together. Today we're going to be doing it about hip distance or maybe just inside a little bit more. Okay, it's really important that we are folding our body only to the side. And we're not folding it forward and back, okay? Because normally what happens is, the moment we raise one arm, we tend to dip forward or back. So it's important that we keep our bodies nice and straight, okay? So imagine a wall is in front of you and imagine a wall is behind, okay? So this is just a simple practice of bringing one arm up and then turning to the side and bending to the side. Very important as well to the arm that is not doing anything, that needs to be really loose. Okay, only then can you add more weight to the side of your body. So let's have a go, okay? So nice, back straight, big smiles, and ready to make the half wheel. So as you inhale, I want you to bring your arm up and then slowly turn it. And then imagine somebody's pulling you all the way up. So just stretch your arm, and then this hand should still be loose. We are folding our body over to the side, okay? And trying to go as far as we can, okay? Really stretching on that side and really crunching on this side. So hold the pose, do this with a smile, and make sure you can feel that crunch, okay? So hold the pose and don't hold your breath, yeah? Very important to stretch that side. And try and look up, try and keep that tricep behind your ear, and breathing in and coming all the way up, stretch and fully exhale. Take everything out as we are going all the way down and relax that arm. Now, you'll feel that the whole arm is really charged up, and you can feel that this is really stretched on one side as well. So this is actually, it looks very simple guys, but it's actually quite a challenging pose. So if you are feeling that stretch and if you're feeling that crunch, then we're doing it properly, okay? But if you tend to dip forward, we're not gonna feel the benefits where we need to. So let's try the other side. Take a nice deep breath and start to raise that arm all the way up. Okay, turn it and face the front. Okay, and stretch yourself up. Remember the hand is loose, and we're going to keep that tricep at the side of our head, and we're gonna fold over with our chin up, hand is nice and loose, and we're holding the pose. Three, holding it more, two, and one, and we're gonna come all the way up, breathing in, and breathing out. And letting that whole arm completely relax. So you'll feel everything is really charged up, yeah? So making sure that we are being very, very careful with our sides when we're doing this, okay? And we're gonna bring the attention now, so taking it away from the side, we're gonna bring the attention now to the lower spine. Now, if you recall in Surya Namaskar, normally we do Hasta Uttanasana like this, and then we push our hips out, and we come into on our way down to Padasthasana, we come to 90 degrees. So that's exactly what we're going to do now, but we're gonna do it with our hips slightly apart, okay? So what I would like for us to do, you can do this with your knees bent if that's more comfortable, because that takes the pressure off the legs. And remember, we're focusing on the upper body, okay? So what we're gonna do is we're gonna breathe in, we're gonna raise our arms up, okay? And then from here, I want you to push your hips out. Yeah, push your hips out behind you and travel with your head and arms together, yeah? And you're coming absolutely to a 90 degree angle. And what I want you to do is if you want to bend your knees slightly and try and raise those arms above the head. Yeah? Try and raise those arms above the head because actually that is really, really waking those back muscles up, yeah? So bending your knees just slightly, unlocking them so there's no pressure, okay? And just have a look. If you need to, you can see that it's absolute 90, yeah? So if somebody's gonna come and put a cup of tea on your back, shouldn't be able to spill at all, okay? So keep it nice and steady, nice and steady. You can put the weight onto your big toes as well, and then shift it onto your heels, and then onto your toes again, okay? Hold the pose, do this with a smile, and then nice and slowly, I want you to just bring your hands onto the floor and come into a sitting position. Just rest for a moment, okay? Because we're gonna continue that stretch a little bit more, okay? So, from the pose in the middle of two postures of Surya Namaskar, we're actually going to do Parvatasana now, which is the mountain pose. And in this posture, I think it's very important for us to remember that if you want to take the pressure off the legs, you can bend them, yeah? So your choice completely, guys. Be very careful. anyone with any high blood pressure or migraines, I would suggest to not do this for too long, or not do this at all, depending on the severity of what you have. So just be careful, okay? Can place your hands calmly on the floor and bring your knees together. Now in Bharadasana, this is the mountain pose, okay? We are actually going to be opening our knees out, so not doing this with our feet together. Take your knees off the floor and just keep your knees bent, yeah? Keep your knees bent, and I want you to really try and bring your chest as close to the floor and now to your knees as you possibly can, okay? So if you have a look at my spine, you can see that it's curved in a huge reverse circle, yeah? So huge arc in a reverse, and I'm tucking my chin in. So actually, there's no real pressure on my legs at all. Okay, and the pressure is actually coming onto my back. Beautiful stretch. Tuck your chin in all the way. Enjoy that stretch. Don't hold our breath yet. Very important to make sure that we are keeping our bodies nice and steady with our breathing. And then nice and slowly, we're going to breathe in. And as we exhale, we are going to relax on into a plank pose. Okay? Place your knees on the floor and take your hands off. So give a little rotation of your wrist if you need to, okay? And just giving them a break, because we're going to be using them in our next posture, yeah? So our next posture is Vasishtasana. So slightly challenging one today, but we're going to have a go. This is something we have done before, but it's important that anyone with any arthritis or any joint pain or anything like that, you're being very, very careful. Yeah, so if we're working our upper body, guys, we can't forget that our arms play a very huge part. We use our arms and our hands for everything, so it's important that we keep them nice and strong. Okay, so this is a practice that's all about balance, but it's also about your body positioning and your body weight, because only then are you actually going to be able to hold your body weight up. So essentially, it's a plank, but it's a one-handed plank, and we're opening up. Okay, so from here, what I want us to do is I want us to come into a nice comfortable position. Yep, doesn't matter if your hips are up a little bit, we can bring them down later. Okay, looking a meter or so in front of you. And what you want to do is slightly open your feet out, just slightly. Okay, and then what we're going to do is we're going to take one of our hands, yeah, right hand or left hand, we're going to take it off the floor. Yeah, and making sure that we're nice and steady. If you want, you can bring one leg on top of the other. And holding that pose nice and comfortably, nice and still, nice and calm. And then as you exhale, we're going to slowly come down and stay in this plank position. I want you to stay in this plank position, guys, and really just lock that core, yeah? Really just lock that core, because we're actually going to do the other side now, yeah? So I'm just going to turn to this side. Just hold a plank just there. We're going to be doing the other side now, okay? So nice and slowly, okay? You can position your legs first if you want to, okay? And open up slowly, nice and calmly, and looking at one position somewhere up in the ceiling, okay? Somewhere that is steady, holding the posture with a smile. Doesn't matter if you're wobbling a little bit, you can calm this down with your breath, and nice and slowly, we're going to exhale, and we're going to bring the arms down and place the knees down, and we're just going to relax for a moment in Balasana, yeah? So heads down, you can relax your elbows as well, taking a nice deep breath in and out. Making sure all of our breathing is being done from our noses while we're relaxing, please, in Balasana. Okay, so nice and slowly, we're going to lift our heads, and I'm going to ask you to just come towards the front, if it's facing this way, yeah, towards the front of your mat, because we're going to do Raj Kapot Asana now, but slightly different, yeah? So pigeon posture, yeah, royal pigeon pose we're going to do, but this is using a little bit of our legs, yeah? It's really important. We don't want to completely deactivate those as well. Yeah, so what we're going to do is we're going to come and sit down on one of our thighs, and we're really going to be pushing and crunching the lower back. So this practice is really good for toning, okay? It's really good for strengthening your lower spine as well. And it's also good for back pain, yeah? But we want to make sure that we're doing this practice regularly and not doing it when we're having the back pain, yeah? So don't wait, yeah? Prevention is much better than cure. So let's nice and slowly come and sit on the side, yeah? So you can see I'm sitting with my legs out, and I want to try and bring my leg behind, yeah? So let's start with my right leg. And if this is all you can do, that's absolutely fine, guys. This is about listening to your body, and it's about understanding your body, yeah? So making sure that your hips and your shoulders are facing the front, and already you should be able to feel that crunch, yeah? And if there's anyone here who is able, yeah, to really bring that leg behind, but still maintain that sitting, that's fine. Let that back leg do whatever it wants. That's not really our concern. What we want to do is feel that crunch, yeah? Now, if I'm to take my hands off, yeah, we want to make sure that we're able to take our hands off and be really steady, okay? But important thing is wherever you are, make sure your shoulders and your hips are facing the front. So what we don't want is sitting on that heel, yeah? We are actually sitting on the floor with the side of our thigh, okay? And you can see that there's a huge dip in my lower spine now, yeah? So very, very important. Now, if you're taking your hands off the floor for this practice, that's fine. Also, if you're not, that's also okay as well. But what we're doing is we're just pushing ourselves. We're just pushing ourselves back. Yeah? Pushing ourselves back and really just folding the spine. Yeah? Folding and the lower back muscles, really just folding over. Yeah? Using your hands. And then what we want to do is if our right leg is back, we're going to turn to our left. And I want you to try and look at your leg right behind you. And then try and go to the other side. So what you're doing is you're just essentially turning your neck. Yeah, but make sure you haven't let your chest drop forward. Very important that the chest is backwards while you're doing this, yeah? Making sure there's no weight on the shoulders and really just letting that head come all the way back. All the way back, push yourself, push, push, push. There's no weight on the arms. You're just using your hands, lightly pressure on the floor to crunch that lower spine. And we're going to exhale. And as you exhale, just bring your chin down to your neck. Yeah? Just bring your chin down to your neck. And as you bring your chin down to your neck, you can feel the top part stretch just there, yeah? So nice and slowly lift that head up. Take a nice deep breath in and release that leg. And we're gonna have a go at doing the other side now, yeah? So weave that leg in, okay? And then settle yourself down. Doesn't matter, it's completely fine if you're sitting with your leg bent, but what matters is that shoulder, that the shoulder width and the hips are facing the front, yeah? But if you're able to bring them further back, then that means go ahead, please go ahead and do that, yeah? So being comfortable in how you're sitting, but making sure that crunch is there, because yes, I understand our hands aren't coming off, guys, but it's very important that we're not pushing down on the floor and tightening the body. What we want to do, keep the hands really loose, yeah? And in fact, even if I take my hands off, I should be able to. So even if you're doing it like that, this is probably, you can feel it a lot more with your leg bent and really feeling the side over there, just right at the back where your kidney area is, yeah? Now really just hold that neck all the way back, all the way back, 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 do this in a smile. And then as you exhale, okay, our right leg is now forward, so we're gonna look to our left first, and then we're going to look to our right, yeah? So use your hands if you need to help you twist, okay? And then back into the middle, we're going to breathe in up, and we're going to breathe out, and chin comes all the way down, touch your chin to your chest, take the pressure off your hands, breathing in, and nice and slowly, we're going to exhale, and we're going to relax. Okay, so nice and relaxed. And you can see that I'm now doing a fold forward. Yeah, so really making sure that we're complementing each pose and not putting too much pressure on our spine. Okay, so just taking a nice break now with our back. And we're going to be coming into our final few poses now. So last pose is going to be Chakrasana, yeah? So like a wheel pose, but we want to be nice and comfortable as we're doing this, okay? Today, we're not going to be doing full Chakrasana. What we're going to be trying to do is lift our body up. So again, with arms have had a little bit of a rest now, so we're actually going to try and open up the entire abdomen using our see how I'm sitting now. I want you to just come and sit on your heels, okay? Again, anyone in any joint pain, please be careful, okay? Listen to your body. It knows what is comfortable for it and what isn't, okay? So take your hips off the floor, and we're going to do it from our right hand side first. So right arm on the floor, and I want you to take your left hand off, okay? And what we want to try and do, you can open your legs, the wider they are, the better. We want to try and bring that arm behind us and just let it hang. And even if you want to just keep it up here, yeah, and let your head go, that's completely fine. But what we're doing is we're being very stable on this hand that we've got on the floor, yeah? So lock it, unlock it, whatever is comfortable for you. And just hold the pose 3, 2, 1. And then nice and slowly, we're going to release that hand and we're going to settle ourselves all the way down. And then in our rest period between each side, just quickly rotate your wrist if you need to. And we're going to have a go at doing the other side. So it's really important, guys, to give yourself a little bit of a turn, because when you do that turn, you're able to lift yourself up a little bit more, okay? So here we go. Ready for the other side now. Lift your hips up. And if you can't do any more than this, then just try and stay here. Even then, you're putting a lot of good weight on the arms, okay? So take your hips all the way up. Follow that arm through. If you're putting it just up to the ceiling, that's fine. And if you're bringing it all the way back, that's also fine. So whatever your body is allowing you to do, okay, listen to it and hold the pose. 3, 2, 1. Maybe see if you could go right up to the top. Okay, let your head go and really just feel that head fall on the shoulder. Then we're going to nice and slowly exhale, and we are going to come all the way down and we are going to relax. Good, well done. Okay, you did really well. That's not an easy posture to do at all, guys. Okay, just rotate those shoulders. Okay, we're going to go for one last one now, yeah? So anyone who has got any sort of migraines and things like that, I definitely recommend. Any severe back pain, please do sit this one out. This is Sarvangasana. This is a whole weight of our body pretty much on the back of our neck and our shoulders, yeah? So be careful as you're doing this one. I want everyone to also understand that there's going to be a lot of circulation that's coming down to our heads as well, okay? So being very, very careful when you're doing this posture and making sure that you're putting the right amount of pressure and weight on your neck, okay? So if we lie down, those of you that are doing this practice with me, just lie down. And if you're not, and if you prefer to sit this one out, that's fine. You can just relax in Shavasana, okay? So what we want to try and do, you can do this without using your hands if you can, okay? But if you want to, by all means, you can bend your legs and do whatever you need to. But what matters is on in your rooms and settle yourself calmly against it, making sure we've got some nice pillows. That's completely fine, yeah? But what we want to try and do is we're going to come all the way up, okay? Take our hands behind our ribs, okay? And then nice and slowly, we want to try and just stretch our legs all the way up. Keep them nice and relaxed, okay? Shoulders nice and relaxed, and just making sure that we're trying to get a level of straightness. So right now, if there's a dip at your hip, we're really trying to straighten it up, and that means bringing your chin closer to your chest, yeah? So really just letting the legs go and working those shoulders. So pushing your spine a little bit more, enjoying, holding the pose, 3, 2, 1, and nice and slowly, you can bend your knees and relax into Shavasana completely and just take a moment to relax. So eyes closed and mouths closed, and just feel the whole of the upper body really, really charged up. Taking a nice deep breath in and feeling your abdomen inflate and deflate. And we'll finish with just some moments of relaxation. So please respect to keep your eyes closed and your mouth closed. And just allow that circulation to now start coming down the body and around it as it normally would. So coming away from the head. Visualize. every body part and letting it relax from the toes, soles of the feet, over the foot, the ankles, your shins and your calves, your kneecaps and behind them, your thighs, the front, the sides and the back, entire backside, down your pelvis into the perineum, every muscle, all the way up to your hips. Relax your hips, they've worked really hard today. Bring your awareness to your stomach, relax the stomach organ, diaphragm, chest, lungs, heart, even your ribs, all the way up to your collarbone. And bring your attention to the base of your spine behind you. Start traveling up your spine, taking every back muscle with you, higher and higher up the back, over the shoulders, relax the blades and the underarms, biceps, triceps, elbows inside and out, lower arms, wrists, palms, fingers, tips, and even your nails. And now gulp the saliva, relax your throat, your neck, the sides and the back of it, your chin, your jaw, your cheeks and your ears, your lips, even relax your teeth and your tongue, upper lip, nostrils, up the nose, middle of the eyebrows, relax the eyebrows, eyelids, eyelashes and eyeballs, and come out to relax your temples. And start scanning your forehead from bottom to middle to top to hairline, crown of the head and right at the back of your head where the weight is on the ground. And finishing with a nice inhale and exhale. And without opening the eyes, yeah, we must make sure we are turning to our right hand side, always our right to take the pressure off the heart without opening our eyes. We want to be sitting up nice and comfortably, letting all that circulation now come downwards. Joining your palms in the namaskar in front of you, finishing with our mantra. Sarve bhavantu sukhinaha, sarve santu niramayaha, sarve bhadrani pashyantu, ma kaschit dukkha bhag bhavet. Om shanti shanti shanti. Let's all be happy, let's all be healthy, let's all see the good in others, let us all be without any pain or illness, and may we all have peace, peace, and peace. Let's start to rub our palms together from all that lovely energy that we've gathered, and keeping those heads up and those back straight, we're going to cup those eyes lightly, making sure no light gets in. Feel the eyelashes move inside the dark and loosen the grip and take a nice deep breath in. And as you breathe in, release the palms, start to palm your forehead and take a nice big stretch and a deep breath all the way in. Extend your namaskar all the way to the top. And let's finish with some happy brains and some happy words. And always, always making sure that so namaste, and thank you very much for joining in. I hope you all enjoyed, and I hope you're feeling very relaxed with a charged upper body. So tune in next time. I'll see you then. Namaste.